In this video, we'll look at how we can install Anaconda Python on Windows 11. Anaconda is a distribution for Python programming by which you can install Python along with Python IDE like Jupyter Notebook, Spyder, or so on. So let's get started. So first, we'll download our Anaconda Python. So for that, let's open our browser and we will use the Chrome browser. So when you open your browser, in the search bar, search for Anaconda download. So when you search for Anaconda download, in the first search result you will see the official website of Anaconda. So now let's go ahead and click on this download Anaconda distribution. So once you click on that, here you have to provide your email address to download that. For testing, I will put the dummy email, and here you just click on submit. So once you click on submit, it will send you the download link for your Anaconda. I already got this download link on my email, so I will show you how it looks like. So after clicking on that, you will get the email like this, and here you have this download now. So either you can click on this download now, so it will open in the new browser tab, or you can just right click on that and copy the link. In my case, I already copy my link, so I will go ahead and just paste this. So here you can see we have this download page open. So here we have support for Windows, Mac and Linux. So we're gonna install on Windows system, which is Windows 11. So and for that it has a support for 64-bit, and all the latest processor are 64-bit, so we don't need to bother about 32-bit. So now let's go ahead and click on this. So as you can see, our download is started, which will take a while. We wait till our download is completed. So it looks like our download is completed. Now let's minimize this and let's go to download folder. So when you go to download folder, here you will see the exe file for our Anaconda installation. So now let's go ahead and click on this. Now first let's minimize this. So this is our first page of our Anaconda installation. So here you see the welcome message for Anaconda setup. Here just click on next, and here click on I agree. If you want to go through this all this licensing instruction, you can go through that and click on I agree. And here it will ask how you want to install, whether you want to install just for this user, which is our first option, just me, or you can select all the user. If you have admin access, you can go with all users and click on next. So in the next page, it's gonna show you the location where by default it will install. So it's gonna install under C, program data, and Anaconda 3. If you want to change this installation path, you can click on browse and select your folder based on your preference, but I will go with the default, which is under program data. So I'm good with this path and I will click on next. Before that, if you want to look at the spaces, so it required spaces 5 GB, and I have enough available space on my laptop, so which is good. Now let's go ahead and click on next. So here we have three options which comes as a checkbox. First one, do you want to create the shortcuts, so which is by default checked, and register Anaconda 3 as a system Python 3.12, that is also check, and clear the cache upon the completion. So I will go with the default one and click on install. So our actual installation of Anaconda is started. So it will take a while to install this Anaconda on your system. So we'll wait till the installation is completed. Now, as you can see, during installation, this is setting up the base environment which is gonna be used by Anaconda. Even you can click on show details, so it will see what all the activities are being done during the installation. So now, as you can see, our installation is completed, and here you can see the status is completed, and you can look at all the stay if you like to have it. And now let's go ahead and click on next. So in the next phase, you just see this kind of message, everything you love about Anaconda now available from the cloud with this fully loaded Jupyter Notebook and all other messages. So it is more about advertising. Everything is available on cloud if you like to use it. But we simply just go ahead and click on next. And here we have these two options, launch Anaconda Navigator and getting started with Anaconda distribution. But time being, we'll just uncheck that and click on finish. So our Anaconda installation is finished. Now let's go to our Windows start menu and go to all apps and look at this, what we got in Anaconda. So here in Anaconda, we have Anaconda Navigator, the PowerShell prompt, Jupyter Notebook, Spyder, all this ID. So first we'll use this Anaconda prompt and check our Python installation. Use this Python hyphen version and click enter. So here we have this Python 3.12.4 which comes along with the Anaconda. Now let's see how we can use the Anaconda Navigator. So here our first one is Anaconda Navigator. So to launch it, just click on that. So it is initializing your Anaconda Navigator, which will take probably 1-2 minutes. So when we launch this Anaconda Navigator, here we have few warning messages. The first one is about update. So here we have three options: no, don't show again, no, remind me later, and yes. So if you want to update that, you can click on a yes. If you don't want to update it, either you can use first or second one. So I will go with the second one, no, remind me later. So this is the another the advertised speech. Now let's go close this also and maximize this. So here we have lots of software available. Some are already installed, some you can install. So like PyCharm, if you like to have PyCharm, you can click on install. You have AI Navigator, a notebook, Jupyter Notebook, JupyterLab, PyCharm, Spyder. So we'll see how, first we'll see how we can use this Jupyter Notebook. So here we have launch one button. So just click on launch. And here let's use our browser and say just once. So this is our the web-based interface for our Jupyter Notebook. Now let's go inside this desktop. And now let's click on new and create new folder. And I will say Python. And we'll go inside Python. And here again, let's go to new and create the new notebook. So here we'll go with this Python 3 and so select. So this is our first notebook. Let's rename this notebook. So I will say sample and say rename. And here you can type your program. So I say print and use hello world, and to run that we have this button. Just click on this button. So here you can see the output of our first cell. Same way you can use x equal to 10 and say print x, and again let's run this. So you see the output for our x variable which is printed in this notebook. So this is how you can use the Jupyter notebook for your Python programming. Let's again go back to the navigator, and let's same way let's launch the Spyder. So here let's click on dismiss. So when you launch this, so this is the default the files which is created under C users and the Spyder py3 temp. So this is the one of the sample files. Same way let's use this here, say print and say hello world, and here we have this run file. So click on run file with default configuration, and click on run. So here in the console you can see the output of our program, which is hello world. Same way you can have this variable x equal to 10 and say print, and you can say value of 10, and let's print this. Sorry, let's use this comma. So here we have this output hello world and value of 10. This is how you can create and run the Python program using the Spyder IDE. Now again let's open over this command prompt, and using this you can install the packages also. For that just use pip and say install, and let's install pypdf2 package and run enter. So our pypdf2 Python package is being installed, rather is successfully installed. Let's see the packages. So for that you say pip list. So you will see all these packages which comes along with the Anaconda Python installation. So let's see. So here we have this pypdf2 which we just installed. So this is how you can use this Anaconda prompt to install Python packages. Yeah, that's all for this Anaconda Python installation process. Hope this video helped you to install Anaconda Python on your Windows 11 system, and help how you can run the Python program using a Jupyter Notebook or Spyder, and install the packages using Anaconda prompt. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.